All right, round one. My opponent chose to play first, which I'm a fan of. I like drawing in this format, so this hand is acceptable. No blue mana yet, but don't really need it. Oh man, between Astrolabe and Benthic Explorer, we could be looking at a real quick Riven Turnbull. Now I've actually got to make that decision. If I go turn 3 Astrolabe, turn 4 Benthic Explorer, I could drop Riven Turnbull on turn 5. And that's why you don't play first, because, you know, you miss your third land drop. Yeah, I think it's much better to play turn 5 Turnbull instead of playing Strike Force Explorer nothing. Aw, that guy's kind of annoying. Well, on the other hand, my opponent's pretty short on mana, so at some point he's going to tap out and I'll Chain Lightning his guy. With this deck, I've got to be really careful about not playing more lands than I absolutely need, because I've got two recalls in the deck, so the more the more lands I have in my hand is the better. Alright. White. Turn into black. Turn into Turnbull. Of course, he's still got the Spiny Starfish out, but I'll deal with that at some point. So, I've actually drawn all lands since my opening hand, I think, which, it'll be fine. I mean, I can't really get in there because of that starfish, and I guess he'll probably leave mana up now, but, let's see. It does restrict his mana by one every turn. Could always Chain Lightning the Longbowman if I want to play the Strike Force. Well, looks like he's tapping out for something. Path of Peace. Alright. Well, never mind then. Yeah, I guess I'm gonna get his guy. Still need to play a land here because I could draw one of my, you know, many 7 mana legends, and I would like to be able to cast them. Well, see, on the one hand, he's only got 4 lands. On the other hand, that means he's got 6 spells in hand. Alright. Oh, there's Recall. That works for me. Bash. Time to cash in my stuff. X equals 3, yeah. I could get those same 3 cards back, but that wouldn't be very good. Alright. Yeah, that's decent. Decent draw. So it's my 3 spells versus his 5 spells. And Astrolabe's not that good. Oh, let's see. In a blue-white deck, there's not that much. He could have a bunch of horsemanship guys. That'd be kind of annoying. Mana Vortex. This card is terrible, isn't it? Yes, that card is actually terrible. He not only has to sack the first land. Like, I mean, I did discard 3 lands, but I've got more lands than he does in play. That is, I guess he stops me from casting the turn. I don't see how this can go well. Now I wish I hadn't discarded a land to get Astrolabe back, but I mean, who plays around Mana Vortex, honestly? My opponent just cast a very slow Armageddon when I'm ahead on the board and have more, well, we'll see what happens. Yeah, Strategic Planning seems like a fine card to play. Hmm. So I could get a banishing, but I'd have to cast it, like, right now. And what am I going to banish? Like, if I banish his Benthic Explorer, I still can't really attack into his guys. Or I'd get a Soul Grail, and... yeah, I think that's going to help me more. Wait, I can't cast it because of Benthic Explorer. Well, never mind, I can fix that. Not that he can actually block my werewolf with his starfish anyway. Alright, well, let's get him. I think I might as well actually just finish off his explorer here. I can cast Soul Grail next turn, it'll be fine. Yeah, I don't see what this Mana Vortex is doing. And we know he's got a ton of like lands or spells in his hand, so who's gonna break it? Play a bunch of green ramp spells, like Three Visits or Spoils of War or whatever. That would be an interesting combo. So this goes away once all the lands are gone. Alright. You are gone. I guess I actually need to name red here. I'm not going to play my land. I'm going to assume all the lands are going to go away, although he's just going to lose to that anyway, but might as well not play a land since I can't actually cast anything anyway. No real reason to attack with the Benthic Explorer. Yeah, this is a weird game, I guess, when people play spells like Mana Vortex. Yeah, that should do it, actually. Alright, well, I guess they just tossed it with this weird... Armageddon's usually not good when you're behind on the board. Don't have any sideboard, probably. Nope, not really. That Spiny Starfish is actually pretty annoying. I can kill it with Immolation. I can, my lesser werewolves can get by it, but it stops all my finishers. It's okay. If I've got like a 5-7 out and then I just time up his guy and attack, that might be good. I don't know. The only sideboard cards I really have are if they have Caracas, Sight and Evil Presence. That's nice. Yeah, it's kind of funny that fairies is a green tribe in this particular set. There's also a fairy noble, which is like a green and two for a 1/2 flying fairy. Oops, don't want to get that in there. A green and two for a 1/2 flying fairy. All your other fairies get +0/+1, and you can tap it to give all your other fairies +1/+0. Got the Willow Priestess, which puts fairies into play. Got Scribe Sprites. You got Fire Sprites, I think is what it's called. Which is a green and one for a 1/1 flyer, and you pay a green and tap it and add a red. I think that's all the fairies I can think of, but yeah. So basically an unimpressive tribe. It's a bunch of like two small flyers and guys that don't really do anything. Although I've seen a couple black green or red green aggro decks that have a bunch of flyers, a bunch of like Jungle Lion, which is a green for a 2/1 that can't block. Although originally it said can't intercept because it was portal. And those decks are fine until like I play a 2/4 or like a Prodigal Sorcerer or whatever, and then they're usually in trouble.